Thank you so much. After yesterday's energetic and very knowledgeable presentation, I think about the whole process, everybody's aware now, what all and at what point, how we see cutting what. Of course, all of that was from performance point so far, I can say. Now, this we are now looking into psychological side of it. We all know performance come, but we do ultimately sell. Of course, when we both are not comparing what is important, and therefore, we see this side of the world, which is the later part, branding. As Professor Ravi also mentioned, that unless it is sold properly, unless it is finding a market, we are not done. Now, I know there are like really, really hardcore engineering products that you are talking about, and therefore, whether the branding actually comes there or not. But let's look at it this way, that there is a consumer base. You know, and it needs to be sold to that. Whatever it could be. Even B2B we are calling, it's not that isolated. It's B2C ultimately. If Intel sells it like Intel processing a computer, I'm really buying Intel by itself, we're buying computer. The computer is getting the role. So that's what we are trying to do here, the value. Like you can read here, the goodwill, that's actually the design can do to your hard work later on. Like these numbers that we use, and these brands also in B2C space, just keep them as examples, not to compare in detail with what you all do. But at your scale also, of course, with the perception value, you can create it. So I did my bit of, you know, doing this mathematical version of branding, getting inspired from the talks yesterday. And if you then put it in the formula, it's a, you know, experiential and emotional edge that you can add. The utility part, of course, you are working hard to create the value. Analogically, I think we're putting, you know, nicely the company desirable. So it is received appropriately when you're selling it out, rather than just a transactional thing, you know, of answering some technical need or usability. We are all humans and we are gifted with emotion, and they are guiding us all the time. And that we call it subconscious side of us. We don't know many things, but we do them often, and therefore, also it came in so many presentations before that, don't probe questions and don't probe people and ask and expect to get direct answers, because nobody knows. Many of the things are happening back of your mind and therefore you're not aware completely. As a user, therefore it becomes very difficult to answer. As a designer, therefore it's much more difficult to get what you're looking for the solution. So that coding is what we're trying to do around and how to do. Technically, okay, there is product, but you see, it's a bigger experience that you create around. The question is, so much, is it necessary all the time? Well, we'll look into it. It's not compulsory. And philosophically, well, let's be humans, because brands are ultimately personalities that we deal with. We have memories in our mind when we look at any product or anything that comes out to us. Those memories need to be created. Memories happen or we can create or cultivate using them. So still why? Let's see this way, that this product or service, there's before and after for that, to that. This before and after is basically where the branding works. You know, while you're using or while somebody is using the product or service, directly interacting, you have done your job, which is going to, you know, cut through, give a better experience, everything, right? But what is before that? The reason to go before is, we know nobody is having time these days. Everybody wants somebody to come and prove you before, you know, they will sell all the money to the product. So this belief first attitude is what everybody is jumping into. Also, and the time is, there is a statistic also on that why people are time poor, cash rich. Money you take but don't ask you to make, you know, that kind of attitude. So therefore some story around your hard work has to happen, and that will of course be by long term. So there are these reasons like differentiation, which are necessity, right? You know, you all the study, you study competition, why it happens, because one of the things is differentiation. Now, in this slide you can see there is nothing written, nothing, but I am sure you are able to identify almost all the parts. So what is working there? There is some, just a shape at that point is working. A simple category now, I'm going a little bit B2C also as one of the examples. A candy, cookies, eclairs and candy. You see eclairs, the category eclairs is not open to kids. It's completely open for everybody. Versus you see on the other side, whatever this brand is, it's on so many other brands, it's open to kids. So there's again one philosophy that whether you want to be the last fish in a crowded pond or you can create your own. So, things like that one can decide, and the programming will work you in that direction. B2B, one of the example again I would say is a Godrej that I was working on. It's completely industrial side, it's electronics and electricals. Can there something happen, life based or emotion based sort of a domain, but yes, it can work there as well. As you can see, the energy that a domain like that would be is there exhibited through visual skin to the brand and of course the language. Memorability, very important. How many times one will keep on investing on bringing it up surface and talk about it. So again, the central part you can see. Nothing to explain about. We know how the brand has been occupying our mind, and therefore many other basic things we need to talk about. So very simple markers can also do the job of talking about your product. Associations is another side to brand, because therefore your product is being seen and perceived in a very different way. The philosophies that we can identify through branding exercises and associate with your product to the usage point when it is happening. If using something, how you feel is very important than just getting your work done. And trust, because loyalty and loyalty about your product is equally important. And next time you should not be selling it so hard. There has to be pull. Again, in business to business model also it works, right? I mean, you can't really every time pitch into your client and convince it hard. So what is that layer that your products or your efforts can have around? In consumer side, of course, there are different medias and different resources that one can use and create that holistic experience. In our industrial side, of course, we can figure out there is nothing like it's not possible basis, and the ideas of media spends or should I go that far, they won't need to be taken so seriously. The reason is there are alternatives available. The last or the epitome of that is whether people have expectations about your product, because that's when you are in their heart. We have expectations from our people that we relate to or that goes to us, or even if we are distantly connected, that the image is there in our mind. We know this brand Apple and the number of speculations that go around before the September 9th of the year and all this internet is filled. So many, because people are trying to do for, you know, what they're going to do, what they're going to do. Is it possible with the work that you're doing? And people have expectations, and therefore the signal is for you to focus in particular areas. So desires, in a way can come back to you as feedback. So how to get there? There are a few steps. I'm just going to talk here, not in detail, but there are ways one to understand basically. So simple question to start with. What's the purpose? You know, why basically we're doing something? It's very easy. Of course, the unique selling point in the branding term or marketing term. What is so special about the product? And why do you feel it's going to cut ice? And what's the difficult part of it? Where you want to go ultimately, and what's the opportunity, right? And how long that will also remain because of the long-term sustenance in the market. So here is how we see it should be there. So the why is perfectly sorted out and clear, and therefore what you are doing about it as a product offering or a service or the design you are working on, how you are addressing the question. Therefore then how to port it or how to build the perception becomes very straightforward. And also designers ultimately get inspired from what they are working on. There are brands we know in the market, everybody is wanting to get the pie of what is available. The first one is the most daring. The second one is okay, there's something there, so I'm getting there. Third one, fourth one, fifth one, I just want to cut the market, just to occupy. So it's always a desire of even the designers to find something new to work on, because they can really work hard on it and make it to the next level that it should be. So ideally, if there is a genuinity at the base, as what we are seeing here in so many presentations, if that is there, you can be very sure that the end product or the end image of your work will be fantastic. So this is too much elaborated, people. I think we are not, even the last exercise that we did is that from the user side, from the problem side, be them, wear their shoes, see from their eyes, feel it. So this is very important in branding. And I think the user or anything that we study needs to be very always from different point of view. So therefore should not be questioned. And should we bother the user so many times? Therefore, is he going to run away? Few questions, because now we're talking about fitting a brand or product in appropriate manner in their lives, because therefore they see it as a desirable time. So there is a simple need, a chart or similar need chart you can find in various ways on internet also. But just for your knowledge, I'm sharing one here. And you see what we do in our daily life. You know, be somebody, want to have something, do something, interactions which are very important. So can we use something like this to map our product and see what is the best association we can have with it? The competition is in the first presentation of it came out, who should work with enemies also, or competition also. So it's very important to see that scenario as well and try to find an analysis which gives us a multidimensional understanding of them. For example, here is just done for a packaging, a consumer cosmetic brand, but this is one of the competitors, right, in international market that is. And then you are seeing how basically the brand has come up around it. So what is the base of the product, what are the kind of products they are offering, what is the kind of brand they are offering, communication, everything comes in picture. And when you are talking a product in the market, the image is very important after the product. A Coca-Cola, we know it's not only one formula that we deal with as a brand. Like that, there's so many brands to talk about, but we'll try to speak to our country and see whether there is any strongest so far that we have. If there is nothing, if the world is saying that, oh, India Times, I think we should try to do that. It's not that it cannot be done. The only thing is, necessity needs to be understood. Marketing side also needs to be given equal importance after the development side. So, here again, one of the things, like if it is about packaging or if it is about or to go in the market, how we are addressing or how we are understanding, you know, what are language they are using, what are the terminologies they are using. Can you fix our destination from where we are? In the journey. Can you map our product against them in terms of the parameters and profits into? Out of all of this, is it helping you find it a chart path, you know, to go ahead? Because ultimately, of course, you will find a way out there, right? Just putting one case in front of you, which is again from B2B space, which is export house that we worked on. This is their newly designed logo and something from the stationery model they had. The question was whether that is actually easy brand. So then, with all the processes that we learned so far, we of course followed that and come to this picture or image you can see, and then I think you yourself can understand what all it adds to the value to follow the. So this is their new look of completely probably sending India outside to the world. Something utility plus aesthetic in their stationaries and whatever they use in their office daily. So their staff is also having their motivation. Not only the leader should have, but everybody should be in tune. It of course catalyzes the movement. All possible communication that goes in all touch points, be it environment, be it across their customers, inside their plants or factories where the actual work happens. The comfort from all the kind of dress codes that we follow in India, whether something can be done to just quickly fit into it, and visibility of course, because you need to be known outside. Yeah. And so this is the kind of one of the trade shows, of course. And ultimately how to do it there onwards so that they have themselves can take it further. Is that 360 degree important? You know, that's what was the question last time I was telling. It's not there every time because of course that's expense. So just one of the touch points that you can take and use that to build your experience around. So this is another one. A startup coming up with a product fitting into space of drinking and alcohol and all. So instead of me putting it into a negative thing, I should not drink alcohol and therefore I should kill the alcohol. Alcohol people worship, right? Whoever drinks, they like it. And that's what we took it forward. So let's encourage that drinking but get the control in the. So this therefore have this encouraging statements which are numerous and put on the packaging. This is not expensive at all because in the process we know at the time how many bags get printed. So there was no expense to the client at all, and on top of that it's interactive. So the user can use it also to invite somebody. This is our case each bag. So it fits into the occasion, it fits into the life, they can use it and you are done. Also the disparity of selling, you can see the competition in Himalaya, so the pharmacy shops to the liquor store, dark to white, you know, disparity. Nights and days, it will be taken care. So design can of course do magic, if we work even from the inception, it can do. These are a couple of other cases like to international brands, right? So this is the way in the last exercise we try to target exactly what you know product and you know trying to open up mind. This is like that. You forget about the product but get the thought a philosophy in it and associate with the brand. Right? So there is a star that drinker may get on its name in the it. The thing is, you should not forget people, otherwise they will forget us. Thank you. If we can. Questions? Thank you so much.